But let's turn right now to Cisco Systems. That stock down after reporting earnings as well. Let's get the numbers and the reason why the stock is off nearly 3% with Josh Lipton. Josh.
So, Brian, I checked in with Alex Henderson over at Needham. He covers the name. I just want to get his take on the print. His point was actually, given the weak conditions in Europe, the exposure to APAC, frankly, he told me he thought it was going to potentially be a lot worse. In his opinion, the guidance here, it was fine. The security segment looked good. Did call out Q2 product orders. That could explain some of the weakness we're seeing here in the after hours. A decent print is how he would put it. CEO Chuck Robbins is on the call right now. He's talking to analysts. He did call out these big secular growth drivers that he thinks are going to continue to benefit Cisco in the quarters ahead. So by that, he means 5G. He means the move to the cloud. He did say, though, talking about his customers, the trends and themes he's seeing in the quarter, that we are seeing, he said, some pausing from customers. They are still planning on moving forward, he's telling analysts, but they are just a bit more cautious right now given the macro environment. He also talked about the coronavirus. We'll see how that plays out. Brian, back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Josh. Last night on the program, Dan, you said that Cisco Systems, while the company itself may not be that big of a deal macro, that you were really interested in these numbers. They were important because it was the first major tech company that had a little bit of exposure to Corona.
Yeah, that quarter ended at the end of January. I mean, to your point, you know, you just said, is Q1 a sort of a mulligan for a lot of companies reporting? And so, you know, why was this important? We know the dollar strengthened over the last few months. We know that Cisco's a company that has 40% of their sales outside of the U.S., so they're exposed to a lot of places where that dollar can kind of hurt them. The trade tariffs, obviously, with China, and then this coronavirus. So, you know, I mean, listen, I think last quarter CEO Chuck Robbins said that it's a very uncertain time. I think he's kind of continued that thought process, but it doesn't seem worse than it was 3 months ago in November. So the stock just ran from 46 to 50 today. It's giving some of that back. The options market was implying about a 5% move in either direction. These are important to remember. In August when they reported, in November when they reported, they guided down. So here they are guiding for this current quarter, kind of in line, but it's important to remember that they're expecting sales to be down 3.5% at the midpoint or so, or 2.5% or so. That's just not great, and that's not in this market. You're not going to get rewarded for that. This is a stock trading 15 times, well below the S&P at 19 times, well below a lot of its mega cap tech peers. I just don't see why you step in and buy this thing here, given the uncertainty.
Yeah, and it seems like, oh, I'm sorry, Tim, quick. It seems like it's cheap at 15 times, but you have really no EPS growth, and the guide wasn't great. I mean, the quarter was fine. The guide wasn't great. And to Dan's point, we went from basically 43.5, 44 mid-December to current levels. This is where, by the way, we topped out at back in October, if you go back and look. So I think this probably retests, given a benign tape, which clearly we haven't seen. Benign tape, this retests the December lows, in my opinion.
So, I've been pretty constructive on Cisco. Also, I think the valuation is interesting, and I can't change that today. I was reading a Cowen report where they highlighted an interview with Chuck Robbins from Davos, where he basically said, we're not seeing any change in end demand. In other words, it's not getting a whole lot better. I think the expectations were out there that this wasn't really extraordinary. And back to our conversation on, obviously, the look into the snapshot of where enterprise is right now. It's not getting a whole lot better. I mean, their service provider kind of routing business is something that you want to see pick up, but it was not something that was a big stalwart. I still think that Cisco's exposure to software and services, especially around security, are why you get margin improvement in this company, and I think it is attractive.
You know what's amazing, too, is with the growth of traffic on the internet. We had Akamai, the CEO, on CNBC earlier today. They benefit from video compression, obviously. The more videos you watch and your kids watch, the better it is. Network traffic is only growing, but when you look at any of the names in this space, Juniper, Ciena, anybody that's sort of a – none of them are doing well, Tim. It's not like this whole – the internet's booming, but the companies that make the guts, the skeleton –
yeah. So again, I think the there's different places where enterprise spending has actually been fine, and you haven't seen a hiccup. I think you have seen it in hardware, and I think we're certain. There was also some seasonality in terms of where inventories were. So it's been a tough place to invest, and I think those names you just mentioned were the ones that people sold first on trade war, and then you know the coronavirus is a dynamic that obviously is hurting them more. I think it was more of a trade war issue for those names.
Yeah, Cisco Systems. So nobody around the table is.
I am.
Well,
I'm.
You're a buy-ish.
But, here's the thing, and I'll just take the other side of it real quick. There's just no reason to buy it right now. I mean, unless you can kind of put your finger on a calendar and tell you that this corona thing's going to be out of the way, that global growth is going to reaccelerate sometime soon. Yes, there might be a backlog for orders for these guys. I think incrementally, I think Robin sounds a bit more constructive. But to your point about hardware was down in the quarter, high single digits percent year over year. Software, you know, security was up high single digits, but it's right. much smaller business. So, yeah, you know, you may get that margin fixed, but revenues are not growing at this company, and I don't know why you reward this for much more than it's trading at 15 times.
I don't think you have to reward it. I think I can own Cisco at a time when mega cap tech stacks are moving and seeing liquidity surge. And that's not a reason to buy any company, except for the fact that I think the valuation here is very defendable. It's tough to bang the table on a company whose top line is gonna decline 4% this year. The market is waiting to see this business be transformed. But right now, you're not overpaying for it. And buying this on weakness when, again, if you're buying the weakness, if the weakness is that this guidance was overly conservative, I'm not sure what you've been looking at. So I mean, the guidance wasn't going
to
be better.
Sorry to interrupt, but you just used the term overpaying. So here's what's going to happen with Cisco in the next year. They're going to have to overpay for some security assets. So they have $28 billion in cash, $20 billion in debt. This company has made a lot of significant acquisitions over the years, and that's what they're going to have to do. If they're going to get that security revenue component growing, you know, faster than the decline in the hardware, they're going to have to make more acquisitions. Where valuations are right now, is it a great time to be buying high growth businesses? I just don't know, you know? They're going to be a buyer is what I'm saying.
I don't think Cisco has to chase anything here. I mean, it's still a company that you say with the cash on the balance sheet and the positioning of the business. Security is trading at very different multiples on the software side. You're right. But I don't think you're assuming that they have to go in and make a bad acquisition.
Well, my point is how long can you underperform the broad market in the biggest bull market that's ever existed? We all think Chuck Robbins is an amazing CEO. And he always talks
IBM.
About.
I mean, IBM's trying to do the same thing. So I'm not saying we're all saying the same thing. This company has underperformed. I don't think going out and buying it at 15 times is overpaying.
This debate was almost Ackman iconish.
Almost.
I mean, that was almost that debate. I thought we were talking about the food company. I had nothing to add. All right, we maybe need an online poll on Cisco.